the robots are coming, or maybe the robots are already here. If you're not in the robotic space or are not actively checking for it, you might be surprised to learn how integrated robots have become in certain corners of our world today. Amazon already has over 750,000 mobile robots deployed across its operations worldwide. We're already seeing amazing labs showing the incredible capabilities of their robots. Boston Dynamics has been the most popular robotics company. And Tesla's Optimus joined the party not long ago. But in the last year or so, the number of innovative companies that have sprung up is nothing to scoff at. In another video, we discuss robots actively involved in war. In this video, we'll talk more about the humanoid robots that help with our everyday chores, as well as robot workers in factories. If you're ready to explore the land of intelligent walking machines, and so am I, let's dive in right away. Before we discuss the exciting humanoids out there and what their various capabilities are, let's first glance at some of the exciting research happening in some of the top universities and labs across the world. GOAT is a robot that is basically a Roomba with a hand and understands directions. You ask it to locate an item and it maps out its environment to locate either the fruit basket that was requested or the cup on the coffee table. One of the main issues with robotics is the time it takes to gather high quality data to train robots. Labs are finding cheaper and faster ways of teaching machines. For example, Meta's Dobb-E only requires 5 minutes of demonstrations, while ALOHA from Stanford University can execute more complex tasks that involve a lot of movement at a cheaper scale. Another way to train robots is to do it on very powerful computers. That's how the folks at the University of California, Berkeley, trained their humanoid robot. They ran different training samples on GPU clusters that were equivalent to 10 billion sessions a day. In some sense, it shows you how dumb robots still are, requiring billions of training sessions to be able to walk in the wild seems so absurd. But the rate at which these robots are advancing is nothing short of breathtaking. Nowadays, labs are also enabling robots to teach themselves. Google DeepMind's SARA-RT uses large language models and visual context to understand their surroundings and perform tasks in the real world through trial and error. SARA-RT manages up to 20 robots simultaneously and has produced 77,000 trials across over 6,000 tasks. Imagine walking in a room full of robots perfecting their craft. That's exactly what SARA-RT does. These are all fascinating projects I would like to explore, but we do have even more interesting humanoids to discuss in this video. We'll talk about a few more robots before we get to the likes of Neo and Figure One. I'm building momentum here.
It just got interesting!
Stanford Snore is also another project I talked about in one of our videos. You basically control a robot with your brain. You can perform a host of household activities, including even petting a robot dog, all based on signals from the brain. This is especially essential for people with neuromuscular problems or physical injuries in the future. Agility and dexterity are also crucial in robot development. Boston Dynamics has been great at it over the last decade and more. Here, we have an example of Carnegie Mellon's robot that is trained to open all kinds of doors, similar to Boston Dynamics' bot. Abs is another robot from the university that can move quickly and safely in messy places. Unlike older methods that were either slow to avoid accidents or fast but risky, Abs teaches robots to move fast without hitting things or people. It is able to switch between speeds, all based on what it learns. This way, robots can zip around both indoors and outdoors, avoiding both still and moving obstacles. Another lab from Tokyo integrated GPT-4 with its Alto-3 humanoid bot, which allows it to perform spontaneous motions. It can pose like it's taking a selfie or pretending to be a ghost, without needing specific programming for each motion. It's a bit creepy, to be quite honest.
You are creepy as sh**.
We are pretty much deep in the uncanny valley with this one. We've discussed 9 robots across different labs, so this should give you a sense of the types of problems scientists and engineers are solving in the field. Now, we'll discuss 4 humanoids that are leading the pack commercially. We're excluding Tesla and Boston Dynamics since they already have a ton of coverage online. Let's begin with Magicbot. MagicLab's humanoid robot showcases skills like marshmallow roasting, magic tricks, and dancing. Magicbot has great object manipulation capabilities. The lab also shows how its robot can do a flip, similar to Boston Dynamics, although this one is without its upper body. Not much info has been released about the project, but I'll keep an eye out for it. Next up, we have the smiling robot from Norway. 1X Labs has been making significant strides in the development of humanoid robots, particularly with its latest models, Eve and Neo. Here we see Eve packing items or cleaning up a living room. The company has support from OpenAI and focuses on creating robots for a variety of applications, including household chores, factory work, and security purposes. 1X teamed up with Evron to provide 140 security androids as a way to increase safety and also address worker turnover. The androids patrol the assigned areas and monitor the environment through high-quality camera feeds. In case of emergency, a worker can take control of a robot through VR teleoperation, allowing remote operators to control and interact with them from any location worldwide. Their Eve android is 6'2 and can go up to 6 hours on a single charge. Neo, on the other hand, is 5'4 and can operate between 2 to 4 hours. Neo is their bipedal android still in development. Its body is engineered with a muscle-like anatomy instead of rigid hydraulics, so they can be strong and gentle like humans are. The company recently completed a 100 million Series B funding round. This goes to show you how much hope and confidence investors have in the future of robotics. Eve is currently available for purchase, ranging from 1 robot to an entire fleet. Agility Robotics, based in Oregon, is another company focused on developing advanced robotic systems. Their 5'9 robot, Digit, is a groundbreaking bipedal robot designed for a range of applications, particularly in logistics and warehouse operations. Digit is one of the early humanoid robots planned to be deployed en masse for work in warehouses and distribution centers, capable of moving seamlessly in human design spaces. The company recently announced the opening of their RoboFab, a manufacturing facility dedicated to producing up to 10,000 robots a year. That's an insane number of robots if you think about it. Digit is being tested to assist in Amazon warehouse operations, particularly in recycling totes.
The fact that it can enter places that were designed for humans and solve those challenges that exist without having to rebuild the environment for automation.
And it doesn't quit.
And it doesn't quit.
They're about $250,000, so they're not inexpensive. But, you know, over just a few years, they're worth it.
It's $250,000, sort of a bargain.
It kind of pays for itself if you think of it as 2 or 3 shifts.
This is further evidence of Amazon's commitment to having more autonomous agents throughout its supply chain. The final company we'll talk about today is Figure AI. The company has emerged as one of the leading robotics companies to watch out for. Their maiden robot, Figure 1, is designed to accomplish general tasks. With the help of neural networks, the robot can map out the steps to accomplish a task until it gets it right. In this video, it learned to make coffee by watching humans.
Hey, Figure 1, can you make me a cup of coffee?
Hey,
figure AI has the backing of some big investors like OpenAI, Jeff Bezos, Microsoft, and Nvidia. Maybe these companies know a lot more about Figure 1 than the rest of us. They recently raised $675 million from their all-star investors, valuing the company at $2.6 billion. That's a lot of money. The funding aims to fast-track the robot's launch and commercialization for general-purpose work capable of learning and interacting with its environment. In contrast to the specialized robots produced by other companies, Figure AI also has a partnership with BMW to deploy its humanoid robots in the car maker's facility in the US. Over the next few years, we'll see more factories sign these types of deals. Robots don't get tired, don't have to go home, and are only limited by the downtimes when they have to charge. Figure AI has a master plan. They want to eventually have their robots take on undesirable and dangerous jobs in factories. They want to take care of the elderly and have the robots in their homes. In the distant future, they want to deploy robots into space to explore new worlds. All our sci-fi fantasies are unfolding right before our eyes. We still have a long way to go. There are still several issues with robots today. They're slow, can only perform limited actions, and they're still very expensive. Goldman Sachs researchers already estimate current rates between $30,000 and $150,000 per unit, up from a range of $50,000 to $250,000 per unit last year. Costs will come down. Robots will be faster with efficient models like what Google DeepMind developed in SARA-RT. Here's Tesla's Optimus, which is 30% faster and 22 pounds lighter than the previous version. It's expected that the humanoid robot market will reach $38 billion by 2035, and more than 250,000 units could be shipped in 2030. The obvious dilemma is how this will affect jobs in the future. What about safety guardrails to protect humans in case of unforeseen circumstances? The hope is that humans will transition into other jobs that don't require a lot of manual or repetitive tasks. A gradual and smooth transition of the workforce is what's important here. Imagine a few years from now when Amazon suddenly deploys millions of robots across its factories. Where do all the displaced workers go? Robots will be an everyday norm soon. As we stand on the brink of technological advancements that once seemed like mere fantasies, it's clear that the future of robotics is not just coming, it's already here, reshaping industries, enhancing human capabilities, and potentially redefining the way we live and work in the 21st century. Let me know what you think. Thanks for watching Beyond Today. Until the next video, it's goodbye.